My name is Dr. Ellen Jorgensen, and I'm the president of a nonprofit called Biotech Without Borders. Synthetic biology is an attempt to make the process of modifying organisms' DNA, in essence genetic engineering, to make it more modular and to make it simpler to automate. If you think about it, it's kind of like having a set of Lego blocks that you can put together in any combination that you want, or computer code where you can take a piece of the code, a routine that works, and paste it into another place. If we could sufficiently define what a piece of DNA does, when we build biological circuits, then we can operate not at the level of A's and T's and C's and G's, but at the level of, oh, here's a piece that has this function, let's paste it here. We've been editing genomes in one way or another since the 1970s, but we've never really been able to edit them precisely until new technologies like CRISPR came along. CRISPR is a genome editing system. It's essentially a word processor for genomes. It's a way of going in, making a specific change, and none of the machinery that makes that change is left in the cell. So CRISPR is a system that we hijacked from bacteria that they use to defend themselves against invaders. And part of that system makes a very precise cut in the invading DNA. So we took that part of that system and we paired it with our cells' natural ability to go in and repair damage. And together, that makes a genome editing system that's more powerful than anything we've ever had before. So this past summer, a couple of groups actually edited human embryos in order to fix a specific genetic defect. And that was made possible by this technology known as CRISPR. Within the 5 years or so that the system has been in use, we've gone from its first use in a test tube to editing a human embryo. So the progress ramp is exceedingly steep. And so I think that a lot of the science fiction of the past 100 years has been around what will happen when we can edit humans. And it always seems to be 10 years in the future, that the future is here now, that some of these technologies that we've been talking about are now actually reality. What are we going to do about them as a species, as a country, as a planet?